Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I am going to discuss the second part of an introduction by Kamala Das. I was a child and later they told me I grew, for I became tall. My limbs swelled and one or two places sprouted hair. When I asked for love, not knowing what else to ask, for he drew a youth of 16 into the bedroom and closed the door. He did not beat me, but my sad woman body felt so beaten. The weight of my breasts and womb crushed me. I shrank pitifully. Dear friends, Kamala Das here describing her miserable married life. She changes our focus from language to her personal life. As she physically grew, her parents told her she has grown up. When she asked for love, she got nothing but pain, because she says, when I asked for love, not knowing what else to ask, for he drew a youth of 16 into bedroom and closed the door. So here is the painful description. Though she reached puberty at the time of her marriage, however, she was not prepared for her sexual encounter. Her miserable marriage life made her traumatized. She says that she was not beaten by her husband, yet her body felt to be beaten. Kamala Das also adds, the weight of my breasts and womb crushed me. So at an early age, Kamala Das was married. In her autobiography, My Story, Kamala Das has revealed that the anguished persona of her poetry, which is also evidently derived from this traumatic frustration in love, marriage, and finally urges her to quote unquote run from one gasomar love to another. Sadly, realizing that love became a swivel door, when one went out, another came in. Kamala Das's autobiographical element, her miserable married life, is hinted in the previous quotation. The word beaten symbolizes the pain she had in her sexual life. Her husband uses her as an object to quench his thirst for lust, but never loved her. As a result, it devastated her badly. From this experience, we come to know that the poet had no good experience in her married life. Actually, Kamala Das has presented these lines as rebelled against the very first few lines. It is due to this simplification of a woman as nothing more than a body that led her to marriage at only 16. She also places blame on her own body for leading her to this place. Her distinctly female parts, breasts, womb, and the very simple but hint on the very sexual growth that she says, my limbs swelled, one or two places sprouted hair. So this is the general growth, yet she was not prepared for the very emotional and very sexual position in which she was thrust, not only by the husband but also by her parents, because she was told by her parents, by her family persons, that she has grown up. So the traumatized and tortured female persona within her was pitifully tortured, and she was in a kind of pitiful condition because she says the pressure placed on by her husband and by her family led to an emotional and mental shrinking. It was a pitiful process. That's why she says, I shrank pitifully. Kobi bolchen, ami shishu chilam. Tarpore ora amake bollo ami boro hoyechi karon ami lomba hoyechi, amar pa duto mota hoyeche, আর শরীরের দু একটা জায়গায় চুল গজিয়েছে। যখন আমি ভালোবাসা চাইলাম, এটা না জেনেই যে আমার আর কি চাওয়ার আছে, তখন সে এক ষোলো বছরের মেয়েকে বেডরুমে টেনে নিয়ে গিয়ে দরজাটা বন্ধ করে দিল। সে আমাকে মারল না, কিন্তু আমার অসহায় নারী দেহ যেন ভীষণ আহত হলো। আমার স্ফীত স্তন আর গর্ভের ভার আমাকে ভেঙে ফেলল। আমি কুঞ্চিত হয়ে গেলাম, আমি কুঁকড়ে গেলাম। আসলে ফ্রেন্ডস, অ্যাকচুয়ালি দ্য পোয়েট ইজ স্টেটিং হার মিজারেবল ম্যারিড লাইফ। সি মুভস টুয়ার্ডস হার ম্যারিড লাইফ ফ্রম চাইল্ডহুড স্টেজ টু দ্য স্টেজ অফ পিউয়ার্টি। ইয়েট হার সোল ওয়াজ ইম্যাচিওর। অ্যাজ সি ওয়াজ স্টিল এ চাইল্ড, সি আস্কড ফর লাভ, বাট ইনস্টেড অফ লাভ হার হাজব্যান্ড কোয়েন্সড হিজ ওন লাস্ট অন দ্য বেড। দ্য পোয়েট হেয়ার নট অনলি ডিসক্রাইবস হার ম্যারিড লাইফ বাট ট্রাইজ টু ন্যারেট দ্য স্টোরি অফ এভরি ওয়ামেন ইন হার কান্ট্রি। হার গ্রিপস অ্যান্ড সরোজ আর দ্য গ্রিপস অ্যান্ড সরোজ অফ এভরি ওয়ান ইন হার কান্ট্রি। দ্য ইয়াং গার্লস ইন হার কান্ট্রি আর ফোর্স টু ম্যারি ওল্ড ম্যান উইদাউট হ্যাভিং দেয়ার কনসেন্ট। দে আর ম্যাচিওর্ড, দ্য হাজব্যান্ডস আর ম্যাচিওর্ড, বাট দ্য গার্লস আর ইয়াং। দে আর সো ইয়াং অ্যাট দ্য টাইম অফ দেয়ার ম্যারেজ দ্যাট দে ক্যান নট অ্যাকসেপ্ট দ্যাট দে হ্যাভ গ্রোন আপ। হাউ এভার অ্যাজ দেয়ার বডি পার্টস ইনক্লুডিং দ্য জেনিটালস গ্রো আপ, দে হ্যাভ টু অ্যাকসেপ্ট দ্যাট দে আর ম্যাচিওর নাও অ্যান্ড দাস হ্যাভ বাউন্ড ইন টু দ্য নাপসিয়াল অ্যানায়ান্স। সো দ্য ম্যারেজ ইজ এ কাইন্ড অফ বার্ডেন, দ্য বডি বিকামস এ কাইন্ড অফ বার্ডেন টু দেম। So instead she is drawn into the bed and made to endure the pains of sex that she is not willing to do. This was the condition, this was the married life of the poet. And so she says that she was not beaten directly by him, yet her womanly body felt to be beaten and wounded, and thus she got tired of it. Then I wore a shirt and my brother's trousers, cut my hair short and ignored my womanliness. Actually, because of Das's painful experience in marriage, she was tired of her body and womanliness. Therefore, in a fit of frustration and protest, she defies the gender roles set by patriarchy. Actually, it is the voice of the feminism, it is the voice of feminist that comes out. She wore a shirt and her brother's trousers and cut her hair short. So she says, I wore a shirt and my brother's trousers, cut my hair short and ignored, ograjjo korlam, my womanliness. Dress in sarees, be girl, be wife, they said. Be embroiderer, be cook, be a quarreler with servants, fit in. Oh, belong, cried the categorizers. Don't sit on walls or peep in through our lace-draped windows. Be Amy or be Kamala, or better still, be Madhavi Kutti. It is time to choose a name, a role. Don't play pretending games. Don't play at schizophrenia or be a nympho. Don't cry embarrassingly loud when jilted in love. কবি আসলে এখানে সমাজপতিরা তাকে যে বাধ্য করেছিল, অ্যাকচুয়ালি পুরুষতান্ত্রিক মানসিকতা যেভাবে আমাদের সমাজের মেয়েদের দমিয়ে রাখে, তারই আসলে একটা প্রতিফলন এখানে দেখাচ্ছেন। তিনি তার বৈবাহিক জীবনের কষ্টটাকে কাটিয়ে ওঠার জন্য একটা শার্ট আর তার ভাইয়ের ট্রাউজার পরলেন। তিনি বলছেন, চুল ছোট করে কেটে ফেললাম আর আমার নারীভাবকে অগ্রাহ্য করলাম। শাড়ি পরো, মেয়ে হও, বধুর মতো থাকো, ওরা বলল। কারুশিল্পী হও, ভালো রাঁধুনি হও, চাকর বাকরদের সঙ্গে ঝগড়ুটে গিন্নি হও, মানিয়ে নাও, ও কারো অধিকারে থাকো, চিৎকার করে বলতে লাগলো সমাজপতিরা। আহ, দেওয়ালের উপরে বসো না, আর পর্দা সরিয়ে জানলা দিয়ে উঁকি মেরো না। অর্থাৎ মেয়েদের কি করা উচিত আর কি উচিত নয় সেটা নিয়েই যেন সমাজপতির চিন্তা। নারীরা স্বাধীন হয়ে যাবে, মেয়েরা তাদের মতো করে কাজ করতে পারবে, এটা তাদের নাপসন্দ। অ্যামি হও, নচেত কমলা হও, তাছাড়া সব থেকে ভালো বরং মাধবী কুট্টি হও। এখন যে কোনো একটা নাম বা ভূমিকা বেছে নেওয়ার সময় ছলনার খেলা খেলো না, সিজোফ্রেনিয়া বা মায়াবীর মতো ভান করো না, ভালোবেসে আঘাত পেলে জোরে কেঁদো না, বলো না যে আমি এক পুরুষের সাক্ষাৎ পেয়েছিলাম এবং তাকে ভালোবেসেছিলাম। টু অ্যাভয়েড দ্য বার্ডেন অফ দ্য ম্যারেজ লাইফ সি ট্রাইড টু বিকাম এ টম বয় বাই অ্যাডপ্টিং দ্য অ্যাটায়ার অফ দ্য মেলস বাট ইট ওয়াজ নট লেড বাই হার ইনলজ অর ক্যাটাগরাইজার্স দে স্টার্টেড টন্টিং হার সি ওয়াজ কমান্ডেড টু ড্রেস ইন শাড়িজ বি আ গার্ল ওয়াইফ এমব্রয়ডারার cook, quarreler with servants, etc. She was asked not to hide her real self. Her in-laws or the categorizers even commanded to remain silent and endure her unachieved love. Actually, these lines expose the condition of a woman in the house of her in-laws. She is forced to give up her frankness and attain the nature of a daughter-in-law. She is forced to do everything that her in-laws desire her to do. She has to accomplish all the tasks, though she is not willing to do so. Still, she is taunted, scolded, as well as abused. She is even advised not to express her grief if she is troubled in her married life. Don't cry embarrassingly, they say, loud when jilted in love. As she was a woman, she was asked not to sit on walls as it was against the rule or peep in through their lace-draped windows. She was asked not to pretend at schizophrenia. Actually, schizophrenia is a mental disorder in which the person suffers from delusions and withdraws himself or herself from the reality. By acting as a male or dressing the male attire, she is not following her role in the female. She seems for them someone who has lost connection with reality. They even asked her not to cry out when she is abandoned suddenly in love. So, through these lines, actually, Kamala Das is presenting the very tortured condition in the very patriarchal society. It was the imposition of societal norms on the ladies, on the women. I met a man, loved him. Call him not by any name. He is every man who wants a woman. Just as I am every woman who seeks love. In him, the hungry haste of rivers. In me, the ocean's tireless waiting. Who are you? I ask each and every one. The answer is, it is I. Anywhere and everywhere, I see the one who calls himself I in this world. He is tightly packed like the sword in its sheath. আমি এক পুরুষের সাক্ষাৎ পেয়েছিলাম এবং তাকে ভালোবেসেছিলাম। সেই মানুষটিকে কোনো নাম ধরে ডেকো না। সে হলো যে কোনো একজন পুরুষ যে একজন নারী চায়। যেমন আমি যে কোনো একজন নারী যে ভালোবাসা চায়। তার মধ্যে নদীর ক্ষুধার্ত ক্ষিপ্রতা, আমার মধ্যে মহাসাগরের ক্লান্তিহীন প্রতীক্ষা। কে তুমি? আমি জনে জনে জিজ্ঞাসা করি। উত্তর আসে, আমি। যে কোনো জায়গায়, প্রত্যেক জায়গায় আমি এক মানুষকে দেখি যে নিজেকে ডাকে আমি বলে। এই জগতে সে যেন খাপের মধ্যে দৃঢ়ভাবে সংযুক্ত তরবারি। Actually, in between the distress, she met a man whom she loved. She does not call him by any definite name. For her, the man is every man. He is like every man who is in need of a woman to quench his thirst of lust, as every woman seeks love from a man. When she asks each man about their identity, the answer is I. It is the I that is found in men. The I or the supreme male ego is stuck to a male personality like sword in its sheath. যেন খাপে সংযুক্ত তরবারির মতো male personality বা male ego stuck করে আছে। Here she uses the simile just like a sword is always affixed to its sheath. In the same manner, the I and male personality are always bound together. It is I who drink lonely, drinks at 12 midnight in hotels of strange towns. It is I who love, it is I who make love and then feel shame It is I who lie dying with a rattle in my throat. The poet says that this I or the male ego gives him the liberty to do whatever he likes. He can drink at midnight, laugh, and satisfy his lust. However, he feels ashamed after losing a woman due to his own shortcomings. And also, this ego of I dies when the person dies. And thus, his end is no different than the end of a woman. Actually, through these lines, the poet has projected the power politics of the patriarchal society. It is because of I that man has got the freedom to do anything he likes. He can drink at midnight, at strange hotels, in unfamiliar towns. He can travel everywhere. So it is because of the eye of the male, he can laugh the way he wants and quenches his thirst. However, after that he feels ashamed at the thought of losing his willpower in front of a woman. So this is the gender bias. I am sinner, I am saint, I am the beloved and the betrayed. I have no joys that are not yours, no aches which are not yours. I too call myself I. Actually, this is the identifying of the poet herself with the I. So at the end of the poem and introduction, we see several role actually played by the persona. She says, I am sinner, and at the same time, I am saint. So this is the reversal of roles. She actually identifies herself with the I. She is sinner and saint. She has done many virtuous things and committed many vices as well, just like everyone else. She loved and had a painful experience of betrayal. Since there is no difference between her and the man in terms of joy and sorrows and experience, so she too declares herself as I. This is how, at the end of the poem, the poet asserts her identity in the male-dominated society. Kobitai bolchen, Ami papi, ami sadhu, ami pranoyeni, abar ami thokechi. Amar emon kono anondo nei ja tomar noy, emon jantrona nei ja tomar noy. Amiyo amake, ami bolei daki. Ashole, এখানে বক্তার পুরুষ শাসিত সমাজে নারীর স্বাধীন মনে বেঁচে থাকার যে সমস্যাগুলো সেগুলোই উঠে এসেছে বক্তার মুখে যখন ওরা বলছেন বারবার সেটা পুরুষতন্ত্রকে কষাঘাত করছে অ্যান ইন্ট্রোডাকশন বাই কমলা দাস ইজ অ্যান অটোবায়োগ্রাফিক্যাল অ্যান্ড কনফেশনাল পোয়েম দ্যাট ভয়েসেস আউট হার কনসার্ন অ্যাবাউট প্যাট্রিয়ার্কি স্টার্টিং ফ্রম পলিটিক্স টু সেক্সুয়াল পলিটিক্স An introduction by Kamala Das encapsulates her personality as it expresses some incidents of her life, her rejection of patriarchal norms, and her rebellion against the gender role as well. Numerous poets have written on the struggle for equal rights in their own lives or in a wider community like Das has. The confessional nature of this poem is one of the many elements that make it relatable with Awakening in New York by Maya Angelou, Mushrooms by Sylvia Plath, or even the confessional tone of Sylvia Plath's Daddy can be mentioned here. I Cannot Live With You by Emily Dickinson and A Married State by Catherine Phillips. To talk about the themes, Das explores powerful themes of feminism, equal rights, freedom, and marriage in an introduction. This poem is a very clear feminist statement that advocates for free choice for all women. This is in regards to every aspect of life, but the poet puts a special emphasis on marriage. She compares and contrasts the roles of men and women in society, and explains for the reader how her life, the rules she is forced to obey, infringing on her freedom. Readers should be able to ask themselves while moving through the poem how, if at all, the things Das is talking about apply to their own life. If nothing matches up, they might ask themselves why, and if some kind of unaddressed or unacknowledged privilege is making their lives better. And to say about the structure of the poem and introduction, we can say, and the introduction has irregular rhyme. It does not follow any specific rhyme scheme or pattern. However, Kamala Das uses literary devices like ellipsis. Ellipsis is a figure of speech which is excluding some parts of a sentence by using three dots. Kamala Das often uses ellipsis in her poetry. In an introduction, we see the use of ellipsis in then dot dot dot. I wore a shirt and my brother's trousers. Cut my hair short and ignore my womanliness. ये तीनटी डट एटाके एलिप्सिस बला है. एंजेमेंट व्यवहार करेछेन, कमा व्यवहार करेछेन प्रचुर परिमाणे, लाइन ब्रेक करेछेन, क्लज व्यवहार करेछेन. आई डोंट नो पॉलिटिक्स बट आई नो द नेम्स अफ दोज इन पावर एंड कैन रिपीट देम लाइक डेज अफ उइक और नेम्स अफ मान्थस बिगिनिंग उइथ नेहरू. এই যে সেন্টেন্সটাকে তিনি অনেক জায়গায় ব্রেক করেছেন, ফলে এনজয়মেন্ট ব্যবহার করেছেন, রিপিটেশন আছে, মাইন ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ এই শব্দগুলোকে রিপিট করেছেন তিনি, অ্যানাফোরা ব্যবহার করেছেন রিপিট করে, অ্যালিউশন ব্যবহার করেছেন. অ্যাজ ফর এক্সাম্পল, আই নো দ্য নেমস অফ দোজ ইন পাওয়ার, রেফার টু মেন হু হ্যাভ বিন রুলিং ইন্ডিয়া, দ্য politicians have been referred to. The language I speak becomes mine, refers to the struggle of women to be treated as human in a patriarchal society. However, he drew a youth of 16 into the bedroom and closed the door. Here he refers to her husband satisfying his lust. Alliteration is also used. Very brown, born in Malabar. Brown, born. B sound is repeated. So, to conclude, we can say that Kamala Das's poetry, as I have already said, is feministic in approach. A woman in Indian society is always instructed to observe the well-established norms of the male-dominated family. The poet realizes that her experiences are the experience of every woman who are devoid of love and liberty. Kamala Das is aware of her feminist identity and asserts it in her poems. She rebels against the exploitation of women in a male-made world and opposes all well-established conventions and norms of the society. One of the common features of Das's poetry is the honest expression of her privacy. This honest expression of Das's personal life is what Mary Ralker called the bitter service of womanhood. But a closer observation, it becomes clear that it is not a nudity on seats of weeklies, nor a wanton display of thighs and size, nor yet merely a case of from bed to horse. Kamala Das's persona is no nymphomaniac. She is simply, quote unquote, every woman who seeks love. She is the beloved and the betrayed, quote unquote. However, she remains the eternal Eve who proudly celebrates her essential femininity. According to K.R.S. Iyengar, quote unquote, Kamala Das is a fiercely feminine sensibility that dares without inhibitions to articulate the hurts it has received in an insensitive, largely man-made world. By identifying herself with other suffering women, Kamala Das transfers her personal anguish into a universal one, and her poetry become a bold pleading for feminism. I hope, friends, you have a glimpse of the poem and introduction written by Kamala Das. Thank you, friends. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and like and share. Thank you.